yeah, they marked it down. I'm just like, yes, that's what things should be. Thank you. Like,
they should be affordable.
Oh, yes. I would have killed to have beers last night because beer has become my, like, socially acceptable muscle relaxer.
Socially? Yeah. Yeah. I'm gonna tell that one to my dad. He'll like that.
Yeah, just like my socially acceptable one nowadays is, well, eh, my boss doesn't need to know about it. Edibles.
Yeah, meanwhile, I just do everything in the cheap or blue-collar way. Blue-collar workout, I go to a job where I lift heavy things for other people. For anti-anxiety for years, I just used cigarettes, and that actually worked.
My dad... I love my parents getting fucking old. Like, my dad gives me jokes all the time. My dad's jokes are so bawdy. He was like, you could use it in your show. And I'm like, yeah, no, I can go ahead and try that one on my show. I have never told a single joke he's told me on my show. Like, they are so fucking... I'm just like, Dad, I don't think you understand what a social climate it is on the internet. Like, that'd be funny back in your day. My day, I'd... Somebody will make a tweet. No.
Hashtag cancel rabbit.
No, don't hashtag that.
No.
No, that's
not
free.
Cancel the rabbit. We stand the rabbit.
No, it's free advertising. No, go for it. Go make it happen.
No. If we want,
what a story that'd be. How'd you get that partner tag, Rabbit? Well,
now here's a better question, Rabbit. Would you rather us get cancel rabbit trending or rabbit's feet trending?
Considering I'm not even regarding the second one. What do you think the answer is?
one of them sounds like an interesting story. The other one sounds like the start of a Markiplier video that just came out a few days ago.
Well, no, because then you'll get a bunch of weird stuff, but then there'll always be the few outlier tweets that just go in there like, oh, got my lucky rabbit's feet today.
No, I was going to say, I'll just tweet out, I finally have rabbit's toesies.
I don't know how to feel about any of this. This is great.
If it makes you feel better, Rabbit, it'll still be less toxic and cringy than most Minecraft trending.
I'll let you on a fun little secret. Nope, I had a joke. I don't know. Nope. Lost it either. I ain't telling that one. Fucking God damn it. Rabbit's toesies, huh?
Rabbit's little toesies.
Not gonna lie, like, I haven't even
Have just an obsession. Like, one day I will add your toesies to the roll.
Good, I'll accept it.
Now we know why he rolled a character with hooves.
I didn't even think about that, but that's fucking funny. That's fucking funny right there.
Oh my god.
Alrighty, well, welcome to this, ladies and gentlemen.
This thing that we're doing, apparently. Oh my god. Well, hopefully everybody else had a good week this week. We finally got snow in my neck of the woods.
I'm just using grandma recipes. I'm just stretching money out. You'd be surprised how many things you can make with rice and a couple of veggies thrown here and there.
Yeah. Yep, like stir-fried beef and peppers.
Just like first Cowboy beef. Bebop intended. It's just, you know, about the beef, but you know.
Exactly. But yeah.
Just a couple of inches of stuff. Yeah, you and me both, Chief.
Man, I'm starting to default to yodeling. What is wrong with me?
You're from Minnesota. It's no shape of the imagination. That's where yodelers live. Like, that's where some of the best polka in America is from, is Minnesota.
Yeah. You gotta thank for the border we share with Wisconsin, there's a few Germans up here that like to bring their polka up that way.
Look.
Okay, that sounds like these damn Germans and their polkas.
Look,
hey, I'm German. I can get away with saying that shit.
Look, you can hate it as much as you want. I think it's super cute to go to like I went to one years ago. I went to like this beer hall that they opened up for Oktoberfest, and like everybody wore like really cute outfits. Look, I think Lederhosen looks adorable. Okay, I know it's supposed to be work clothing, but I'm like, oh my god, we all look so doofy, and it's so cute. Like,
well, Lederhosen is great.
And you hear the polka music, and it's so friendly. It's like an RPG village. It's so cute.
Well, Lederhosen also exists for one other thing. I have ridiculously defined calves, and I need some way to show them off.
It is true.
You get the tightness on the thigh that draws the eye down to the calves. Yeah, it's perfect.
Dude, when I went there, I drank with some grandpa who just, like, he had power. Like, he was just, like, withered on everywhere but his calves, and it was just weird. Like, it was just boom! I'm like, Jesus Christ.
I mean, say what you will about Minnesota, but at least one thing that Wisconsin's good for are the Oktoberfests. I went to one in Milwaukee that was just, top tier Oktoberfest. Massive stein, get all the beer you can drink. It was just a rip-roaring good time.
In Ohio, we love drinking during holidays because that's when we get to get drunk wearing hats.
It's similar in Missouri. It's a legal reason to drink outside until it's not. Then the cops just have to worry about it.
The same thing in Texas, where it's like, oh, you're having to get the other out? Well, okay, how much alcohol is going to be involved? It's just a thing you have to worry about.
I'll never forget my B-cop when I lived in downtown in my hometown. Officer Wilkos, he was so fucking funny. Like, I was super drunk. I was like 24, 25, and it was New Year's, so I drank champagne, knowing full well what that does to me. I was like, hee-hee, bubbles. And then, like, at the second glass, I'm like, bubbles. And
by the third.
And so, like, oh my god. It's weird. With beer, I can go ahead and pound beers and ciders. Anything slightly above that, it trashes me every time. I don't even know why. Like, people are like, you want whiskey? I'm like, sure. Knowing full well what whiskey does to me. And I'm like, just like, you only had a shot. I'm like, I know. Like, and so, like, I was pretty hammered. I was walking, and he was just like, oh, can you make it home safe, Matt? And I'm just like, yeah, I can. Yeah. I was like, all right. He's like, all right. And so I'm walking. It's winter, you know, there's snow everywhere and whatnot. And Wilkos goes ahead and, like, looks back, and he goes, hey, Matt. And I'm like, yeah, officer. And I'm like leaning on, I look like Frankenstein when I'm walking, like my shoulders up on a building to prop myself. And I'm like, yeah. And he goes, don't you live in the other way? I'm like, do I? He's like, yeah. I'm like, oh, where is that? And so he just, like, lightly just grabs my shoulders and just turns me. And then he just gives me a light push. And I'm like, thank you, Officer Wilkos. Well, he goes, he's like, Happy New Year, Happy New Year.
having heard you tell the story one time before, you missed out on one of the best details about it. It's the fact that you're dressed like Inspector Gadget while this is happening.
Oh, yeah! I had my work clothes because I worked office. And so I had, like, this winter fog. I had this winter fog, like, long coat on. So I looked like Inspector Gadget. It was very warm and snug. And so, yeah, if anyone was a fly on the wall, you would have seen, like, an officer just lightly turn Inspector Gadget and just lightly push him. I'm just like, character. And I'm just like, thank you. Happy New Year. Oh, my God. Dude, I was so clambashed at work. I was just like, look, all I'm doing is Excel spreadsheets because my head feels like it's going to crack open. Like, and somebody's like, I got a soup call. And I go, cool, find someone else. They're like, you can't do that. And I went, I did. And I walked into the office. God, I got burned for that one. Another manager on another team lead. because I was a team lead. He was like, you did an Angevin soup call. And I'm like, I'm hungover. And he went, oh, okay, well, that's fine. And I went, how is that fine? Like, how is the, any other time you would have harangued me? How's now different?
Because it's you're paying for your idiocy from last night already.
I still think it's because I could do spreadsheets faster than any of them. They didn't know the shortcuts. I did because I was taught on Windows 95, and they haven't changed at all. Wow. Derek, you fucking mewling baby.
You were molded by Windows 95, crafted by it.
Yeah, I don't know how technology works anymore. It was a miracle I built a computer. I am like computers having two more parts to me going, I'm just buying pre-builts forever because I do not know what elder shit's inside you anymore. Like, I used to. Yeah. Hell, even cars now. I can work on the mechanics out of my car, but my new car has so much computerized shit in it. I'm just like, what the fuck? Like half of it looks like a peeled replicant from Blade Runner. I'm like, what the fuck is this? Like, should it be glowing?
Well, the best question is first, whenever you notice that, you just go all spark and then see if anything happens. If not, you're safe.
Oh, true.
Yep. Especially if it's a Camaro.
No, she's an absolute cute car, though. I love that car so much.
All right. Well, with that being said, just for give everyone else in the chat heads up, Draco will be joining us slightly later tonight, but in the meantime, there's really not that much else going on, so I think we can go ahead and probably kick it live for the session proper.
Yeah.
Welcome, one and all, to session 48 of Chult of Personality. When last we left the expeditionaries, Rue, the human druid monk, Enoch, the human warlock, Elise, the wood elf ranger fighter, Zeno, the half-elf sorcerer, Tyrant Bane, the minotaur paladin, and Dan, the half-elf witch. The party descended to the bottom of the grand staircase inside the Tomb of the Nine Gods. They were greeted by four four-armed gargoyle statues perched upon four large pedestals. Each pedestal bore colored metallic tiles of a copper, silver, gold, and platinum color, and coin-sized slots inside each one. A 10-foot hole leading to the next floor below from which a loud mechanical groaning could be heard. Seeing there was more to explore on that floor, thanks to reconnaissance by Vorn Jr., the party thought it might be a good idea to investigate below, but as Rue went to lower a rope down to the next floor, the gargoyles on top of the pedestals animated, and each tapped the top of their pedestals. Displeased by their lack of tides from the party, they attacked, and after a fierce and perilous fight, our heroes crumbled the gargoyles into rubble. Exploration of a nearby hallway then bore a bearded devil's face, as well as murals depicting a crazed, insane scene. Inside the bearded devil's face was a wizard. A wizard. Jeez. Shoot me now. Bah! Anyway, it was a lizard, in fact. And a lizard, in fact, that could speak druidic, which Rue was able to come in and look upon this lizard. It was discovered that this was, in fact, an awakened lizard, but it also turned out that there was a familial connection, as Rue's father had, in fact, awakened this lizard. And in another weird bout of coincidence, the lizard, Licky, which was now taken up by Rue, turned out to be a sibling of this lizard. So agreeing to help the party in exchange for its liberation, it set out and perched itself upon Rue, also discovering a nearby secret door, which revealed a 10-foot room with a volcano motif and a skeleton holding a red candle at the far wall. As we rejoin our heroes, how shall they proceed? And what awaits them here and possibly the next floor below? Let's find out in tonight's episode of Chult of Personality.
I just realized I was Scoop Cat.
You were Scoop Cat. I was wondering how long it was going to take for you to realize.
Oh, you didn't! Oh, you knew the entire time! Oh, look
I
at
did,
you.
I did, I did. I was smugly
judging me!
I was just gently seeing Scoop Cat did leave the scoop.
Then also, it's just fun seeing Scoop Cat, so I always just let it slide.
God, I love that picture so much.
All right.
Well, that looks menacing.
Slightly.
Oh, that looks just friendly. Don't worry. It's probably non-lethal, probably.
Fine.
Okay. So, describe the room to me one more time.
Sure. Let me just go ahead and get to that page proper. Da, 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 da. There it is. Waves of heat blast out from this cramped cell. The walls are scribed with relief carvings showing volcano-setting cities ablaze. Rows of tiny holes are bored into the floor and the 10-foot-high ceiling. A human skeleton embedded in the opposite wall holds an iron sconce with a burning red candle in it.
I wonder if this has anything to do with the first riddle.
If I had to guess, probably.
What did you three find over there?
Secret room.
Oh.
Also a talking lizard, but that has nothing to do with this.
Just like to imagine.
I mean, that kind of has something to do with it.
Just like to imagine that they're both perched on either shoulder now.
Sure.
Roru is one of the rare people who can be empowered and speak to the jungle. So it makes... So if... Is that what happened?
No, it just actually talked. She was just the only one that understood it.
Speaks in Druidic. It knew my father.
That's a warm gift, then.
Aha. There we go. There is our last one.
Hey, Draco. Just in time.
Hey, what's up, Draco?
It was a bit of a drive to get back home, but I made it.
You did, and you missed pretty much nothing.
Yeah, we just started Paliwal.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good.
So what's in this room? I say, just peering, like, you'll just see like a snout just appear over your shoulder. Just...
Yep. I'll read the description one more time for Draco, since they weren't here to see this last session. Waves of heat blast out from this cramped cell. The walls are scribed with relief carvings showing volcano-setting cities ablaze. Rows of tiny holes are bored into the floor and the 10-foot-high ceiling. A human skeleton embedded in the opposite wall holds an iron sconce with a burning red candle in it.
So the candle is on fire.
Correct.
Hmm. Do people use different colored candles for things? I doubt it's just to tie the room together.
No, it feels like it might have something to do with fire, which is why I'm curious if this has something to do with the first warning.
The first warning. Let me recall that.
Death to fire, dying or drown, precious air and falling sand.
If it would be the death of fire, maybe someone should snuff it?
That's what I'm thinking, perhaps.
Casually look at my character sheet to see if I'm dying or not.
I am.
Probably. No, I'm good.
Does anyone got a way to blow out fire from a distance?
Hold on, I probably...
Resuscitation.
It's true. I've got it. Let me see. Yep.
You guys say you guys say presentation right when Tyrant Bane just lifts up to like his hand, like I could just, you know, just like
true, but the dying, drowning, buried in sand, we kind of want to make sure that you're not stuck in there.
Yeah, I have druidcraft as well, which can let me do a puff of air.
Though, also, one second, just save us a little bit of time. How magic-y is the room?
You do not detect any magic inside the room.
Huh. Well, it's not magical, which leads me to believe it's more trapped than usual.
Mm.
Well, she points at the little holes. That worries me.
Can a trap be triggered just by the lack of candlelight?
Traps can be triggered by a lot of things, really.
Yeah, depends on the trap, really.
I know snare traps and pit traps. I've never really seen the kind of trap that can be triggered by a candle. But then again, being in here, I've seen all kinds of things I haven't seen.
You'd be surprised
if there's one thing about Withers and that and Aserac, they're definitely traveled. Mm-hmm. Some of these things I've never even seen the like in the jungle.
You'd actually be surprised at how many mechanisms are based off of simple temperature changes.
Really?
So above game, it is a 10x10 room, right?
Correct.
Okay, so above game, here's what I'm thinking. Watch the in character. You know, if need be, I could easily, like, I could be in there. You guys could close, like, if you need to, close the door behind me, and I could dimension door out.
Well, why don't we just try to snuff the candle at a distance first before we try putting anybody in there?
Yeah, Dan has a trick for that, right?
I do too.
Prognosticus or something?
Prestidigitation. It's a very long word, but yes.
That's, Tyre Bane will just say nothing and scoot back and just hold a hand out like, yes, yeah, that was a word. Go. Yes. Did that.
It is quite literally the most useful spell you can ever get.
Agreed. Dan will hold out his arcane focus. Prestidigitatio. And the candle will snuff out.
Except it does not. As you go to cast prestidigitation, nothing happens.
This is a very interesting candle. Can't snuff it out. At least not with magic.
Hold on. Sorry, ignore that for the time being. I'm just reading something.
Also, Dan's gonna hold his stomach.
You can make a poof!
I'm pretty beaten up from the gargoyles. Can someone heal me, please?
I just got done healing Zol, but here, come here. And I will just put my hand on... I will just put my hand on your shoulder and just... a light squeeze, and I'll give you the rest of my lay on hands. Heal for 13, buddy.
Oh, thank you. Above game, I was at 19 out of 63.
Oofta.
Yeah.
That gargoyle tore you to shreds last session.
Yeah, this is why I'm not usually, you know, right up in the thick of it. Circumstances just happen to put me there.
Yeah, that's my job.
I'm pretty sure prestidigitation is pretty much the same thing, but Druidcraft also says you can snuff out a candle. She's just going to try to cast that real quick.
You try to cast Druidcraft, nothing happens.
I could try to pull it out from here.
Take 7 more, Dan.
Thank you.
Enoch just swirls a little cloud of nanites. I could just try to pull it out of the room.
If that doesn't work, you know, like, I'll do it. I mean, I can easily just give away from you guys. You're not in any danger in case something happens.
Enoch, I'll give this to you as you see Rue and Dan go to cast their spells. You see the magic essences from their spells make their way towards the room, but as soon as they cross the secret door, it's almost like they disappear.
Oh, there's a field. A field of no magic.
Tyrant Bane holds up a finger again.
A field of no magic? That's possible.
I mean, yes. I guess.
It's basically casting a counter spell to where it can nullify magic.
Oh, yes, I've seen an elder do that before. Okay.
But yeah, it's
an elder you hear Talad kind of ponder. Perhaps it's some sort of anti-magic field.
Could we use dispel magic to take care of that?
I doubt it. I mean, magic does not exist within anti-magic. Can't dispel it.
Is anti-magic its own thing, or is it a magic spell that creates anti-magic? Well, that doesn't make sense then, because wouldn't anti-magic be magic? But it's anti-magic.
You're getting real hot. You're getting real high concept on me, man.
I am.
I imagine that the field of anti-magic has to be focused on something.
What?
The room? Possibly the candle itself?
Even if I couldn't smite anything or whatnot in there, I could... I'm still a very strong soldier. I could go in and go ahead and snuff it out. It seems like that'd be the most direct option, and it does seem to be the only option we have left.
I don't like it, but you're right.
Above game, I kind of wish we had a leather bag, and we could use the alchemy jug to fill up with, like, a giant water balloon and just throw it
in there. We have 3 gallons of water. I think we have at least a bucket.
Yeah. And if not, we can probably find something similar in this tomb. Like an empty helmet or something.
Well, no. We literally have 3 gallons of water, so we have to have something that contains it. Because you can't just pour water into the bag. We've had this for the better part of our entire adventure.
Oh, yeah. That's a good point.
So... all four just hurl in a bucket of water at it and see what happens.
Water is not magical. At least, I don't think it is.
I mean, it can be. If you cast, like, tidal wave or something, but that's another argument entirely.
I've seen people try to sell magic water before. It didn't work out well for them.
Yeah, back in the college, they had a thing called spicy muck water.
Rue?
Here we go again.
You're starting to feel the heat coming out from inside this room.
If you're going in there, I'm going with you.
All right. The two of you set foot inside the room. You're currently 5 feet away from the candle. What do you do?
Ha-cha-cha-cha. All right. Druidcraft again. Can I snuff it out this time?
You go to cast Druidcraft, and nothing happens.
Do you want me to just snuff it out, or do you want to do the honors?
Go ahead.
Okay. I can do that. And Tyrant Bane will just lick his cow tongue will extend. Have you ever seen a cow tongue? Look up a video.
They're very big.
They're very big tongues. Just... he will go and just lick his fingers for a second and go, just hover it over the candle and go, fip.
As you go to approach the candle and touch it, I need the two of you to make dexterity saving throws.
Oh, I'm good at those.
You get a +4!
Ray!
At 20.
Woo!
Oh, no.
15.
I have to ask you the important question because the... I'll say their lizards are protected because why not? Alright, so... Alright, Tyrant Maid, you pass. Rue, you fail. So, as you feel the heat kind of make its way up, the lizards just kind of go and duck in, and you take... Hold on a second. Alright, so... ...14 points of fire damage as lava goes... pours out from the ceiling and bathes the two of you.
Hold on a minute. You take half.
You take 7 points because you passed.
So I'll take 14 and you take 7, Kayla.
Okay.
And as the two of you go to snuff, as you go to snuff the candle, everyone outside the cell sees the two of them vanish.
Oh no.
Oh, not again.
Alright. I'm gonna have to reveal this. Oh, actually. Oh, that's right. As you step foot into the cell, also your flame tongue longsword goes out.
Oh, fantastic.
So, instead, you immediately begin to choke as you are teleported into a room with no light, no sound, and no air.
Oh, boy.
As... What do you do as you are...
Hold on.
Well, I think I got a picture for this.
Of all the people we put into a room with no air, and it wasn't me.
And
you notice after a while, after they disappear and the candle goes out, the candle lights again.
Oh, geez.
Okay.
So what do I do? What I put in memes. That's what I'll do.
In me. All right. I am going...
Yeah, pretty much.
Light.
You go to cast light, nothing happens.
Not real.
Alright, so, Tyrant Bane, what do you do?
As if on reflex, I'm going to grab Rue's arm and I'm going to go ahead and back my other arm to the side and see if there's a wall or something while I'm holding my breath as only a cow can.
Make a perception check for me as you do that.
Oh no.
I'm going to use my inspiration. Check this out. That's a 13.
You go to grab Rue, and you feel there's one wall that's currently off to your right. And as you feel around, you feel like there are ridges that are along the wall, and the more you feel about it, the more you feel like there are bones of some sort that are kind of stuck into the wall.
I'm going to... does it feel like stone?
Or is it just like... stone, but it does feel like bone, too. The parts that stick out feel like bone.
Okay.
And as you go to moving around, it kind of feels like there's a little bit of play that comes from the bones.
A little bit of play that comes from the bones?
Yes.
Awesome. I'm going to grab the Minotaur's friend, the battle axe, and just hack into the bones.
All right. Make an attack roll.
As a 14.
All right, you hit the battle axe, and as you go to knock the... You go to knock... You hit the... Oh, man, words are hard for me tonight. You attack one of the bows that are on the wall. Make another perception check for me.
Six.
Not
really my greatest strength. Scene. Doing anything right. That requires brain thought.
Alright. So, Rue, you feel a hand that's grabbed on as a tire bait. You hear the sound of tire bait striking against something, and you feel something rattle on the floor.
Feel around for it.
Alright. You feel around, you grab a bone that's been knocked off the wall, and as you do, you kind of feel the ends of it. Feels like there's wax at the end of these.
Wax, huh? Does it feel like a candle?
It does not feel like a candle. It just feels like bone. That feels like it has wax at each of its ends.
How are we doing on air, by the way?
This has been one round. What's your constitution modifiers?
6.
What's my constitution modifier? 2.
All right, so you've got one more round before you start suffocating and losing air, Rue. Tyrant Bane, you've got a little bit of time yet.
I'm not worried. I can take care of both of us if need be. But for the time being, Druidcraft.
All right, so fire. It's weird. You go to cast Druidcraft. For some reason, you see it flare up for a split second, but it immediately goes out. But there is still no air here.
Have you ever tried to light a match in a really windy day? That's what I imagined right there when you said that.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay. I mean, there's no oxygen.
Once more, puff of wind.
There's no air to move around. All right, Tyrant Bane, what do you do?
We are swinging into the same spot again.
All right.
Because if this wall is weak, I can try to break through it.
All right, you go to... All right, make another attack roll, I guess.
As a 12.
That'll hit. And as you got to hit with a battle axe. Tire Bane, Rue, I want the two of you to make perception checks again.
All right.
11.
Natural 20.
Ooh.
All right. Tyrant Bane, as you go to hit against the wall where you hear some more of the bones, you hear some of the bones crack. Rue, you swore you could hear some pops that came from the sound of whatever was hit on the wall over there.
Pops.
Like, almost like puffs of air.
I have an idea, but I don't want to metagame.
Well, we also haven't been cut back to.
Yeah.
That is true. So there's still no air, but I heard puffs.
And you have a bone in your hands.
Remind me what suffocation does, because I just want to plan this properly.
All right. Suffocation in 5e. When a creature runs out of breath or is choking, it can survive for a number of rounds equal to its constitution modifier. At the start of its next turn, it drops to 0 hit points and is dying, and it can't regain hit points or be stabilized until it can breathe again.
Okay, so I think this is the last round that I could do anything, so yeah. I have to do this now.
What do you do?
Okay, so for my action... I know what it is. Yeah, you can still do your thing. Okay, so polymorph Tyrant Bane. I'm going to turn him into an air elemental, which don't need to breathe. And for my bonus action, I'm gonna do the same thing on myself.
Let's see.
You can only cast two spells a turn if one of them's
a cantrip. It's not a spell.
It's wild shape.
Oh!
Hers is wild shape. His is a spell.
Yeah.
Very clever. Yeah. All right. So the two of you turn into air elementals, which is weird because there's no air. But
they're creating their own because they're elementals.
Yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sure. Right.
So the breathing thing is no longer a problem.
For now.
All right. So as the air elemental, I'm going to hold up the bone and then I'm going to like kind of tap at the spot where I heard the puffs.
Tyrant Bane is just going to look at his hands, not knowing what an air elemental does, and he's going to make like a punch motion.
So for the record, at least for you, you have two slam attacks, and a whirlwind.
Fucking baller.
You're literally the Cyclone Titan from the Disney's Hercules movie.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome. Okay. Because he's never been this, so it's just like, what am I? Like,
what the hell is going on?
I have an identity crisis for a quick second.
He's going to do what he knows most as a Minotaur, and he's just going to go ahead and where she taps, just guide his body into it, and he's just going to go ahead and slam with all of his might into it.
All right. All right, you're just going to slam into the wall for a little bit. You managed to knock some more bones off.
Yep, we're going to go ahead and break on through.
All right.
Like that Who song. Break on through. Wait, no, is that Doors? I can't remember.
The Doors.
It is Doors.
Yeah. So you're going to slam on the doors for a while. Meanwhile, let's take a quick opportunity to cut back to the rest of the party.
Oh, no.
This is exactly why I wanted to go in there.
It's an anti-magic field, genius. You can't teleport out. Dan, can you hold down the fort?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyone else who doesn't mind getting drenched in lava and or molten ore, now's your time. No takers? Okay. Enoch is going to go in and attempt to puff out the candle.
All right. How are you going to puff the candle out?
He literally has a metal hand.
All right, so you're going to snuff out the candle with your hand?
Yes.
All right, I'll need a dex save from you.
Do-do-do-do-do, this will be funny.
It's a nat 20, holy shit.
A lot of nat 20s tonight.
Very nice. So, where'd my other d10 go?
Though, I technically have to make 10 more of those, because I did not drop concentration because I have no other spells, so give me a second. That's a nat 1. 15.
All right, for your animated daggers.
This is why I made 300 of them. No one's just ever attacked them because they're so small.
All right, so 19 points of fire damage on a fail and 9 points on a save.
Well, have any of these saved so far that wasn't me? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
it's
7.
A DC 20, so no.
Oh, well then. Yeah, so all of my arrows just get melted away. And you said
they join their brothers in the magma.
And it's weird, as you're walking in, it's like, huh. And you realize as you make your way into here, your animated objects are still working right now.
Oh?
As you vanish into the other room.
Oh, wow, it's dark in here. Do I hear the sound of wind and destruction?
You don't necessarily hear the sound of wind because it's, quite silent, but above game.
Well, I do also have Detect Magic up, so
There's just a gusty guy and gal in there just looking over at you going, oh, hi.
Yeah.
Didn't see you there.
Yeah, but you go to the for your Eldritch Sight, and you do not detect any magic in here.
Hmm. Well, this is awkward. Enoch will attempt to produce dancing lights.
You cast dancing lights, and you all can see in here.
Huzzah!
You see sculptural reliefs on the walls of this dark cell, showing tornadoes uprooting trees and tearing cities apart. An Arakokra skeleton embedded in one wall holds an iron sconce bearing an unlit red candle. And you also see various bones that are scattered across the floor. Each of them have both their ends sealed in wax.
Huh. Enoch will look at the reliefs of the tornadoes destroying things, look at his two giant wind friends.
It's just gonna be wham! Wham! And then he notices the lights turn on and the whamming just gets slower and slower until he stops. Just go for it, you.
Enoch, realizing that he can't speak for some reason, will just wave.
Just waves back.
He does a Chulten salute.
He'll point at the unlit candle. Well,
they'll just motion to themselves and just, like, kind of shake their head, or shake her head.
Enoch will sigh. He will pull out his flint and tinder from his adventurer's pack and attempt to light this candle.
Due to the lack of oxygen in here, you go to attempt to light the candle. But it does not light.
Can I, like, place my finger as an air elemental by the flint?
That would actually make sense. It provides oxygen.
Hold on, I have to double check. Yeah. You're an air elemental.
Asking the big questions here.
Because I imagine I'm still like a minotaur shape, right? As an air elemental, I just don't have any of my things on me, right?
They fuse into you, yeah.
So I gotta go ahead and reach to my pack. I can't feel it. You just see this air elemental just frantically patting around and then looking at Rue. You can't see that he's talking or anything, but you can definitely see when his gestures, he just has his arms out like, what the fuck? Where are my things?
I never thought I had to ask a question. Can an air elemental survive in an oxygenless environment?
EMD.
They do say that they can survive in the bag of holding, which I imagine also does not have air.
Specifically does not have air.
Yeah, it specifically does not have air. So I'm going to argue. I would at least argue yes.
As an elemental, I'm inclined to agree with that. So
don't make me angrily gust at you. I will throw down a prodigious gale.
So with the air current created by the air elemental, am I able to spark a fire?
You spark? It flickers for a second and then goes out because there's not enough adequate oxygen in here.
I will add my large minotaur air body to the fire.
You guys are technically making a vortex as well. Like,
I was gonna say we're very windy. We need to find how to get the oxygen in here. That's what we're doing.
I'm sorry. This is my first day as an air elemental. That's on me. Like, that's
my very first thought was stand on the candle. Because that's a lot of air, but it would also mean you get set on fire more likely.
Like Rue didn't give me a pamphlet that said, so you're an air elemental now? Like, it didn't, like...
Look, she just didn't want him to suffocate. There was no time for pamphlets.
Well, that's very sweet, but also we should learn
Wait
pamphlet
a second.
Crap.
Maybe I Dan knows something.
Yeah.
No, I think it's... I have a quick question here, since we're now talking about the physics of D&D.
Here we go.
So, a large part of my body is covered in still fairly molten rock and or metal, and I'm also a good chunk metal, which is a conductor of heat. Enoch's just going to reach over.
You use the residual heat from the lava to go ahead and light the candle.
Yeah, that's exactly.
We need oxygen.
We do still need oxygen.
But it's still glowing. It's burning up very quickly. We can just go ahead and just put the candle in the lava. Da, 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 da.
All right. Also, important note. the two lizards that were also with you at this point.
No! Oh no! Wait, can they merge? I think they merge with me, don't they?
Don't you do this to her.
They're flying through the vortex.
I was about to say, you haven't specified what happens to them anytime Rue is wild shaped, and Rue is wild shaped a lot, so.
Yeah.
You know what? I'll say they're just kind of floating in your form, and they just have like a little bit of air. It's like, the one was just like, it's hard to breathe. I need air. That's not for you.
Panicking. Okay, now she's gonna start slamming like Tyrant Bane did, because until she hears those puffs again.
Yeah, we're just gonna like just ram a smash into the wall until it gives.
All right, yeah. So you smash and you get more of those bones that fall off the wall, and as you look, you see that you do see some puffs of air that erupt from the bones as you smash into some of them.
While they're doing that, can I investigate the wax-tipped bones?
Sure.
Touch it with very hot metal.
You touch it. It holds.
Okay. Doesn't break, doesn't light.
I love that Rue is completely stoic until you brought that up and she went, my babies!
Yeah, no, pretty much. That was
motherly
instant
panic. Instincts kicking in. Oh, no!
Meanwhile, Enoch's not in danger at all. He's just like, how do I make this work? I wish I was better at puzzles.
And just two air elementals back and you just flailing, going, ah! Just smacking against the table.
Meanwhile, back with the rest of the party.
Guys,
you all see Enoch
vanish.
I feel
really useless right now.
And the candle is lit again. What do you do?
I mean, not a whole lot we can do at the moment.
No, because if we go in there, we don't know what they're experiencing right now.
Yeah. Does anybody have any ideas?
Come on, Daniel, brain blast.
Hey.
Yuki just deflates.
Kostrick just kind of looks. You see him wave his hands, and as he goes to cast it, the candle goes out. Hey, it works.
What?
And then the candle lights again.
Did anything happen in our room?
No.
Shit!
Not currently. Talad just looks. It appears that the anti-magic field's gone in there.
Okay. So, them going through has gotten rid of the field.
And it seems like if you snuff out the candle while you're in the room, you vanish.
Nothing happens if we do it from outside the room.
See, here's the problem that I'm experiencing right now. Like, if I had gone in there, I could have dimension doored, but I could only bring one person with me. So I'd have to risk going three times, and I don't have that many slots that I can do that spell.
Also, I mean, we don't know where they are. Can you dimension door without knowing your location?
Yeah, that's how I saved Rue the last time.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Above game, like, I don't think if I think Zeta would be the guy, like, if he can't breathe, that'd be the only thing he'd think about. He wouldn't actually think about the actual plants. He probably would have died if he quit in.
Yeah. You know, just for laughs, I'll do another prestidigitation on the candle to see, and try to keep a close eye to see if anything happens in that room when I do it.
You puff the candle out with prestidigitation. It goes dark. And then it lights up again.
Okay. Can I roll investigation or something to see if anything happened in there aside from that? Or no, there's just nothing I can glean aside from what I've seen?
I'll allow a perception check as you do that.
All right. Perception. That's a 9. I don't see shit, Captain.
Yeah, you don't see anything. You thought you heard a swirl of something, but aside from that, nothing else happened.
I heard something swirl, but other than that, I haven't really figured anything out.
I go ahead and just step into the room. I'm not gonna snuff the candle out, but I'm gonna just try to like investigate the room further to see if I can see any mechanism or anything.
Investigation.
18.
Yeah, there's just the skeleton with the sconce and candle there. The various motifs of the volcanoes erupting. It's finally cooled down a little bit more compared to when the lava was in that Bay of Dinoc.
I just had a very silly idea. What's but that? I'm going to need Elise out of the room. What if I just keep casting Prestidigitation and keep it from lighting? Like,
I can help you with that if you need to.
Yeah. That would be great, actually. I do the initial one, then you immediately following, and we just keep doing it and seeing if we can break the mechanism.
Alright.
I'll step out of the room, then.
Or maybe, I don't know what's going on wherever they are, but maybe that'll help bring them back, or... worth a shot.
It is worth a shot.
And, I guess everyone else try to listen in or see if you can figure anything out while we're, for lack of a better term, fucking with the mechanism.
Alright. So you two are going to spend some time just casting Prestidigitation.
Over and over again, making sure the candle never lights.
Yep, so as soon as you see the candle start to light up again, another one of you will cast Prestidigitation, stuff the candle out. And you're going to keep doing that. Meanwhile, back in the airless room,
well, since we haven't tried anything, Enoch's just going to pick up the candle.
All right. You have the candle.
Okay. Nothing happens when we do that.
Mm-hmm.
If anything did, I would have felt foolish for not trying, but okay. He's going to reach a hand inside Rue and try to light it with his other hand.
I'm sorry. I missed out what you asked there. What was that, Enoch?
He's gonna reach the candle inside Rue and try to light it with his other hand.
You go to light it, and it doesn't really. Between the swirling around and the slighter, less lack of oxygen from that, it doesn't really light.
Mm. Wait a minute. You said some of the bones make pops like air real quick, right?
It sounded like it, yeah.
Oh my god, this is so stupid. Are they handing us snorkels? Hold on a minute.
You could hand it to Enoch and Enoch can try. He doesn't need to breathe, but
I'm going to identify one of the moans that made the weird little poppy-woppy noise.
All right. Yeah, you have all the bones.
I will... Look, this is going to sound fucking insane, okay? I can't believe I'm even suggesting this as a... It's not Iron Pain, but Rabbit, a real human being. He's going to make a gesture like you were to put the bone into your... and go... and see if that does anything.
Now, if Enoch was a normal person, he would question this, but Enoch was also raised by goblins, so they handed him a lot of things and with very little context. He'll take it and try it.
Alright, so you take the bones, and you go to break the wax seal, and you notice that there is very stale air that's inside the bone.
Mmm.
Delicious stale air.
Mm-mm.
Alright. Taste of rib dust.
Well then, Enoch will confirm with a thumbs up there is air, and then he's going to put.
Are you fucking serious? This place sucks! This place sucks!
Welcome to D&D, ladies and gentlemen.
This place sucks. What?
So,
what?
Let me just to make sure I have this clear. You're taking the air that's in the bone, and you're using it to light the candle?
Yes.
Okay. You take the air that's right next to it. You go to attempt to light it. It lights for a split second, but then it goes out.
Hmm. Well then.
Are the bones large enough that you can fit the candle inside?
Maybe you have to break them all and fill the room with air?
Air dissipates.
You see, I'm gonna have. You see, while the lizard's gotta go and grab, I was like, it's taking one of its hands and it's trying to reach for the bone.
Yep. No. When we figure that out, Rue is like, immediately taking care of the lizards with air. That is her singular focus right now.
All right. So as you crack open the bone, you give it to the lizard. The lizard vanishes.
Does the same thing with the other one.
You give it to that one, and that one vanishes.
On the other side, do we see lizards just pop up?
Nope. Between the flickering. You guys don't see anything.
There were several clues. I'm pretty sure that this is going to be a circular set of rooms.
Yep. I think so, too. I'll do the same thing and I'll breathe the air in, quote unquote.
All right. You go to breathe the air and you all, Rue, you, I would say Tyrant Bane and Enoch, you see Rue vanish as I have to, let's see. Now I can do things and reveal the map.
True, I only realized that I possibly got to see and chat got to see because I was in the room.
God.
Yeah, Rabbit, I can hear.
Oh my god, this place sucks.
The answer.
Oh.
Okay.
Thanks, Bill Nye.
The science guy.
Alright, so Rue. I grabbed the wrong thing. I need to grab. This tomb is filled with terracotta warriors, kneeling in neat ranks around a polished wooden coffin. Between the warriors, four aisles scattered with broken pottery lead up to the coffin, whose painted lid shows a leopard with serpents sprouting from its shoulders. And you see, right next to you, is one of the lizards. As you're looking down, you see you're standing on this weird rune.
What do you mean I see one of those? Where's the other one? I gave them both air.
Can you see me pinging?
Roll a perception check, because above game, it's probably a little harder to see because, you know, small litter lizard where you're seeing all these statues.
Perception. This is important. I'm using my inspiration. 23.
All right. where am I? You hear from over here.
All right, so both my lizards are accounted for. Okay.
And as you're swirling around, your form's a little, hold up. Where is it?
Airy, gusty, drifty.
It is gusty in here, yes. All the terracotta warriors turn their heads to face you, Rue. As one, they pull their swords a few inches from their scabbards. And they take their other hand and they raise it to their lips.
Hmm.
So I have to be quiet. Easy enough. I can fly. Because I don't think I don't see that glass. Or terracotta, what I'm going to assume. Okay, so I'm gonna float on over here.
Alright. You float on over to the coffin while that's going on. Tyrantbane, Enoch!
Well, Enoch will look to Tyrantbane and be like, go ahead.
Sorry, I am fuming.
you actually have to suck the bone air.
I will suck the delicious bone air.
You suck the bone air, and you appear on the south platform. And you see the swirly form of Ruru hovering over a sarcophagus.
I'm going to look around confusedly.
So, nice thing now that there's, you know, air. We can now talk. But we speak Orin.
You speak Wimdy.
We do speak Wimdy.
Okay. Okay. What in the world is going on here?
She'll just point at the terracotta warriors. They said to be silent.
Am I hovering?
Yes, you are.
I'm going to kind of realize that, because I can get a look at myself now, I'm going to lean forward for the first time and try to hover, because all that was just instinct, just bashing against a wall.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to hover very slowly, baby's first hoverboard. And I'm going to hover over to Rue.
Alright.
Above game, Rabbit, I'm going to make Tyrantbane fly. That's just going to happen at one point.
Well, that's amazing, because then you'll have a 410-pound wrecking ball.
Exactly.
Alright, so, Tyrantbane, you're going to hover over towards Rue in the center of the room. Enoch, back to you.
Mm-hmm. Enoch will just sigh, pocket the candle that that was in this room just in case, and mm-hmm. then he is going to suck the bone air.
You suck the bone air, and poof, you find yourself over here.
Hmm. He'll wave.
Wave back.
I will hold up a, like, shush kind of thing to you, like.
Will you give any more indication besides just shush?
Motions to all of the terracotta warriors.
Okay. Then we'll probably notice all the broken terracotta. Well, Enoch's just going to put out his hand at all of the broken bits and mending.
All right. You just grab a couple pieces and start casting mending. All right.
Well, no. I just reach out and just touch it and then just starts mending.
Alright, so, Tyrantbane, as you're kind of floating around, you get a sense of an unease coming from inside you. Oh, I don't like this place. We should leave at once. Probably through one of the rooms. But I'm not sure which one we should take.
I will look over at, Rue and go,
Is he actually just blowing and not actually speaking Orin?
I don't know what Orin is. So you're like, it's windy. So I'm like, oh, cool, I'll just blow. Translation, Unk is telling me that we should probably be getting out of here through one of the runes, and soon. It really worries her. I can collect your lizards for you.
I was actually just about to say she was going to nod and collect her lizards.
Alright, so while the two of you are doing that, we'll cut back to the rest of the party. As you're continuing to cast prestidigitation and keeping the candle unlit this whole time.
I like the thing that me and Dan are both, like, starting to get, like, okay, this is good, but we're, like, our arms are starting to hurt from trying to constantly cast a spell.
Yeah, as fun as this is, I don't think we're really accomplishing much.
I Probably not.
I just had a thought. I'm gonna cast Sending and message Enoch. Just to see what the hell their situation is.
I'm glad. I was just about to ask there if I could have a bug game. Mention that.
Yeah. Yeah, I was looking through my spells and went, oh, right. I have Sending. We could get a status report.
All right. What do you send the message for? I have a counter handy to count the words for you.
Hey, Enoch. What is the situation? Not sure what to do. You can respond.
Enoch will roll his eyes. We are alive in the last tomb. Very trapped. Figuring out the puzzle. Just wait.
All right. So, they're doing fine. They have found the last tomb. And he believes that we should just wait for them to figure it out.
All right.
So, right. Dan's just gonna sit down and get comfy, I guess.
All right. So, meanwhile, back inside the tomb. At this point, Tyrant Bane and Ruru, you have collected the lizards that were on the platforms.
Yes. Okay. So, what is this thing in the middle?
That is a sarcophagus. With a painted visage of a leopard with snakes on its neck.
The last one, the Jakuli. Listen, I read that several paragraphs enough times to remember what these animals are by now.
Where's my Jakuli in Animal Crossing? That's what I'm asking.
All right. I guess we gotta lift that bad boy up to get the thing.
Well, luckily, air elementals are still strong because they are elementals.
Indeed.
I will assist you with that while we are holding lizards. We are just a mess. We just have lizards in us and pieces of terracotta, and we're just...
If it would help, Enoch would gesture that he could handle the lizards while you do the heavy lifting.
Yeah, she'll accept.
Yeah. Hi there, little friends. I can't understand either of you.
And then they look at you and their tongues just go out real quick.
Blim.
Blim. Adorable little babies.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, I'm going to help Rue lift this, or Rue can help me. Dealer's choice.
Alright.
I'm trying to... Where's my strength? Because I think technically our strength is the same, if I remember correctly.
Oh, is it? Yep. But yeah, but with like two walking like category twos, I'm pretty sure I'll be fine.
Okay, our strength is a plus two.
All right. So, for the sake of brevity, between the two of you, you go to lift the lid of the sarcophagus.
We're also going to try to do this quietly.
And as you do, you hear a slight twang, and you look inside. Well, you hear the plinking of a music box.
Oh, God.
Can I smother it?
And as that happens, the warriors that are all within the room immediately draw their short swords, and I need the three of you to roll initiative.
Pick
So, because of what games I've played, the first thing I thought of when I heard that is I thought, oh shit, the mannequin's about to come out and attack you.
Thank you, Mannequin, the marionette. Really wish I had spells right now.
Let's see.
I
That's a lot of soldiers.
This is unnecessary.
It's an obscene amount.
Useful.
Okay,
what the
so
fuck?
Rabbit, should Tyrant Bane choose to stay as he is, you hold on, where's the thing? Have where the balls did I freaking put the health? There it is. You have 90 extra hit points.
Oh, baller. Okay.
Actually, you know what I'm gonna do?
I think you'll need this against the lesion that woke up.
Here, you know what? I'm gonna put this in party notes for you.
Party notes.
There you go. There's air form.
Where is party notes at? Is it down at the bottom?
It's in the middle.
It's in the middle? All
it's right. Between quotes and memes.
Oh, it's on Discord. Here I am going through roll 20 going, what do I do? Okay. Alrighty.
Alright, so I have to figure out what their dex mod is. Actually, this is actually a good time to take a break while I get this all sorted out.
Great. Because my option is for me to go ahead and just scoop out whatever's in there, scream the runes, and then leaving.
Yeah. At this point, Enoch's just holding open the bag of holding, like, throw it in, throw it in, throw it in.
Come on! I'm gonna go grab some water.
Also, Caitlin, thanks for the braces of defense. I think I'm gonna need them. She's gone. Well, chat, I hope you're having a good time. Oh, I was not prepared for today.
I'm kind of glad above game that I didn't go, but also the same thing. I'm like, these are terracotta soldiers. Like, four or five shatters would, like, do a huge number on these things.
Very true.
It's like, wait, I don't get to... don't literally get to smash plates? God damn it, I want to smash plates.
You want to be the bull in the china shop, but guess what? That tire bait's already filling that role.
I know.
Well, I gotta go use bathroom.
Oh. The worst part is I have so many spells that would help in this exact situation, but I have cast two. The awkwardness of being under a 12th level warlock.
Ah, this place sucks!
I can't sit down.
Don't worry, Rabbit. We're literally in this with you.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Also, I should probably announce this right now for chat. There is a good chance we will not be doing Satire Days on our usual Saturday. We might possibly be trying to get it done on Sunday, but we make no promises. Things are hectic at the moment. I may not have all the functionality in my legs currently, so it's been a week.
I'm about to make fucking lose it at this goddamn dungeon.
Alright, well, now that Rabbit's back, I'm gonna go
I'm
and
sorry.
Get some water.
I'm not
back.
angry!
You're miffed.
I have returned.
He's mad.
I imagine, yeah. Is it still the bone air that's getting him angry?
I'm not angry. Just there has been so much bullshit in this dungeon where I've went, how the fuck does that make sense? And that one wins the grand prize.
Well, no.
The only reason the lizards are alive is because I watched Apocalypse Now. I want you to think about that.
I watched Apocalypse Now. Vaughn, you've watched that movie, you know, when the dude gets shot and they think he's dead and he's in the river, he has the fucking reed in the water?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the only reason!
Meanwhile, I was just sitting there trying not to be a child.
Meanwhile, I mean, I'm just sitting here like...
And then, we go here! We go here! And then we play all the rules. We're silent. We're floaty little bastards. We tell Enoch to not make a sound because we're floaty little bastards. We lift it up and there's a music box in it which nullifies everything. And now we have so many terracotta soldiers that looks like it was made because of a jilted DM who got shafted on pizza.
I could see that, actually, yeah.
What can I say? Withers and a Searacker are assholes.
Yeah, oh, no, absolutely.
Oh, no. No, they are not assholes. No, you've been, no, the maker of this cannot hide behind his OCs. Who made this?
Rabbit now has a lifetime vendetta against the creator of Adventure Time.
Yep. Yes. Oh, good.
Sorry.
He should go back and just work on that. Clearly, making dungeons isn't your forte, Chief.
I like to imagine that a Sirek is just his OC, that it's a self-insert.
If it's the only thing that would make this better, as if when he was rolling this out, a Sirak was the Lich who is voiced by Ron Perlman. Only way to make this better. But guess what? I'm willing to bet the last two quarters that I have that it's not.
I mean, it could be, but I'm not sure we can afford to get him on Cameo for that long.
I'm so absolutely... pesteringly, I'm not livid. I'm just charmingly annoyed.
I was gonna say nettled.
His kimmies are rustled.
Because it's like, the music box was in this thing, and it nullifies all the work that you did. How pissed was Pendleton Ward to do this? And then it summons. Let me fucking count this. 10, 8, 12, 24, 36, 48! 48 of them!
Well, here's just hoping they don't have a lot of HP.
Ward.
He better pendle a fucking ward against me, I'm telling you.
And we don't even have a way to say, okay, suddenly things are not okay.
Would be above game if I do sending again, but I have no reason to not trust you.
Yep. It was one of those things where above game, I was like, maybe you should have told them how to solve the second room so they could come. But you know what? We're here now.
The rune! Just jump on the moment it's my turn. What are we doing? The runes!
Also,
jump on the rune!
Caitlin, I do love that idea, but in character as Enoch, looking at this room before it went active, he would just gesture at all of it and then just mouth the word Zeno and let that speak volumes.
Yeah.
You want to know what the best part is?
Mm-hmm.
You want to know the funny punchline, Caitlin?
Mm-hmm.
Take a seat in your chair. I'm going to tell you the funny punchline.
Mm-hmm.
Are you sitting in your chair?
I have been. I'm very lazy.
Is it? are a peach in my friend group. Are you comfortable?
I am, yes.
Fantastic. You and Enoch get to go first. And then I get to endure getting beaten up 48 times!
Don't worry, Rabbit. That's why you have the extra 90 health.
Oh, goody!
And technically resistance to non-magical damage, which is most likely what they have.
Yeah, exactly. Can I just say we are large creatures, and I'd just like to point out that special? That'll be fun.
I will be good!
Speaking of which,
Bane, you are literally a bull in a china shop. Go crazy.
Oh my god!
I'm so happy.
All right.
Just pokes one of them and they fall over and just create the a domino effect.
Also, Vaughn, when you said you're gonna battle Zeno, like above, like in character, Zeno's just gonna randomly sneeze.
Yeah.
Also, I just want to point out that I'm imagining if Sirak can hear all of this, and he's doing, you know, that gif of the lizard laughing. That's what he's doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's gonna laugh all right when I throw him in a magic circle and summon a ring on him like I'm Randy Savage. I'm gonna beat the crap out of him.
Above game, I'm half tempted to see if I could get my Pollock or someone that cameo the voice of Sirak just to do a couple of laughs.
Oh my god, a Sirak voiced by Dr. Robotnik be amazing.
Yeah. But anyway, before we get started with initiative proper, I'll better describe everything that you see inside the sarcophagus. You see a bunch of gold, 5 moonstones, the music box, and you see there's a fancy looking mandolin inside there as well, a fancy stringed instrument.
How lovely.
So that's all the you see inside. So
it's a lot of treasure that I can't swipe right now.
And Enoch, assuming you have your Eldritch Sight up, you do detect some magic coming from inside the sarcophagus.
Where? Like, considering front end, back end?
Like, inside the actual sarcophagus. Like,
fantastic.
Alright, so, we'll start with the initiative proper. Ruru, it's your turn. What do you do?
Okay, gonna move, because I'm a little bit worried about Enoch having all those on him. Whirlwind, baby.
Alright, so...
all four of them need to make a strength saving throw.
Okay, and as you do that, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4... You'll get 5 attacks of opportunity from the Terracotta Warriors as you move around.
I'm fine.
There's another D20. Actually, I have to double check to see how many attacks each of them get. So 2. Actually, that's their multi-attack. So yeah, it would be just 5. As they attack with their short swords. Let's see. Does a 12 hit?
Nope.
All right. So the only one that hits you is a natural 20. So you take 10 points of piercing damage, round that down to 5 for resistance. And now for the strength saves from those 4. One passes and 3 fails.
Okay, so, let's see.
Just to move for a second. How much damage?
On a failure, the target takes 3d8 bludgeoning and is flung 20 feet away from the elemental and random direction and knocked prone.
Ah, I see. So yeah, go ahead and roll the damage.
Okay. Nope, sorry, that was... that's not what I wanted.
Oh, all so right, still did so 15.
Yeah, 15, I think.
Alright. So... alright, so that one takes that much. Let's see where he gets flung to.
And if the target strikes an object, they're going to take extra damage.
Alright, so...
which, ironically, if they hit any of the other constructs, constructs are also objects.
Yep, so that one's going to get flung into there. And let's also roll for... so what's the additional damage that deals when they hit?
It's going to be another 1d6 for every 10 feet it flies. So I think that was just 1.
Yeah, so they're not going to take the damage from that since they both... alright, so that one is going to get pushed over to there as well. That one's not going to take the damage. This one next to here, however, is going to take 2 points of damage.
If a thrown object strikes the target. Creature that okay, if it's thrown at another creature, the creature must succeed a DC 13 Dexterity saving throw, or take the same damage and be knocked prone. Which actually, I think the one that I was knocked into was already being thrown. So.
Yep. So. All right. So those two are currently prone. So that one's prone. Come on, poke in, please. Thank you.
Vaughn, you don't have to. You don't have to read the sheer indignation on my face.
No, I can feel it.
And also, let's see where that one gets plugged to.
I'm also just sitting here with all these options I could have had if I had spells.
That one also gets plugged into the wall right next to it, and it's not prone. This one passed, so they take half. So, 7. So, like that. Oh yeah, that one was also prone. Alright. So that was all their saves. Anything else for you, Drew?
Alright, and now for my action. Let's see, so I have 2 slam attacks. I'm gonna, the one that's currently blowing away inside me, I am going to make 2 slam attacks.
Alright.
Or at the very least 1 if it's still alive by the time I'm done with that.
Okay.
So let's see, slam, this is an attack with this plus 8. So, that's like 26.
That hits.
Don't you get advantage on any attack on a prone creature?
That is true, just in case I get a natural 20. It's
so
just,
close.
Just short. So that is going to be 2d8 plus 5. 16.
Alright, so 16. Bludgeon. That one is still up.
Okay. Natural 20.
There you go. That one gets crumpled into dust.
Ooh, yeah. Goot.
My kingdom for arrowheads right now.
Do you still have those?
Didn't you keep nope, they up? All got melted.
Dang it.
They only have 10 hit points each.
Eh. Oh, well.
Alright, anything else for your turn then, Ru?
That is all I can do.
Alright, next up is Enoch.
Hmm. Well, seeing how this is going to go, Enoch is going to take the disengage option. Action.
Mm-hmm.
Throw open the bag of holding and then try to just prepare to scoop everything in there into the bag in one go.
Okay. All right. So, I'll allow you to use an action if you want to start scooping the stuff in there right now with, you know, with your free interact object with your bag of holding.
Okay. Then yes, Enoch is literally just taking the bag and scooping it along the inside. He's not even touching anything because he's not going to try to have to switch possessions mid this fight.
All right. It'll take you... We'll say you get about half the stuff scooped in 6 seconds. Then, well, next turn,
yeah,
you should
no.
be able to get everything in.
I'm not the one pulling weight in this fight. I know what's going on.
All right. So, next up are the Terracotta Warriors.
This is fine.
Alright, so. That one's gonna move there. This one's gonna move up here. This one's gonna move up here. That one's gonna move up here. That one's gonna move up here. That one's gonna move there. That one's gonna move there. These ones are gonna move up in rank and file. That one's gonna move there. One's not able to move right to the sarcophagus. So we'll start with the ones that are currently around Enoch.
Number to beat's 19.
Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're gonna get 8 sets of short sword attacks for a total of 16. So we'll start
Where's the 8th one coming from? I see 7.
It is 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, you're right. Yeah, 7.
Please, I'm a squishy warlock who just happens to have really good accessories.
Alright, so the first two... you said your AC was 18, yes?
19.
Alright, so the first round... The first two rounds will miss. Next two... That's one hit. For 4 piercing damage.
Yay.
Number 3. That's one more hit for a 21. For another 3 points of piercing. And the last one. It's 2. They also miss.
Oh, phew.
All right. So that was all of those. Rue, you're going to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5, 6, including the one that is currently enveloped in you. Alright, so the first round. That's a... What's your AC of an air elemental again?
15.
15. Alright, so that'll be... 3 hits from the first two.
Okay.
For... Alright, so 4, half to 2, 3, half to 1, 7, round down to 3, so that's 2, 3, so you take a total of 6 from that after resistances. Next 4, that's 2 more hits. For 2 and 2. So another 4 after resistance. And then the last 2. Those will both hit. So 3 and 2. So a total of 5 after resistance there. Alright. So, Tyrant Bane. You're gonna get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Actually, no. That one attacks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're gonna get a total of 10 sets of attacks.
Poggers.
Alright. That's one hit for 4 after resistance.
Okay. That's I'm just gonna open up my calculator and just... Yeah. Come down to it. All right, yep. So 4.
Yep. So then a miss and a miss. There's another hit. So that's about 4 attacks. That hits for 2 more after resistance.
For 2. Okay.
Ah, crap. Load. Another miss. There's one more hit for 2 after resistance.
All right.
There's another one for another 3 after resistance.
Oh, he's a strong one to the family.
All right, so you got 2 more sets coming. That's 1, actually 2 more hits there.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
So...
We're probably gonna have to try to run.
Yep. 4.
If I have 4 plus 2.
So that's another 6 after resistance, and then one more round. One miss, and what's in that 20?
Uh huh.
So
So that's 8, 10 rounded down to 5.
Okay.
And that's literally everything that they can do.
Sweet.
That brings us to you, Tyrant Maid.
Cool. Grab the bag, grab the Enoch, scream runes, fly toward the room.
Sure. All right, I'll allow it.
I should point out I don't have everything in there.
Oh, assist him scooping the rest of the shit in there. Then grab Enoch, then go to the runes.
All right.
I have wind. It'll be like a leaf blower, but with treasure.
To be fair, if he pulled me to him, that would pull me the rest of the way through the sarcophagus, shoveling everything in the bag.
Yeah, I'll say as part of your movement, you do manage to make your way through there to that. And meanwhile, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
He's protected
11.
By my gusty body.
You're going to get 11 attacks of opportunity on you.
Radical!
You'll be fine.
I'm here.
All right, so of the first four, you get one hit for one after resistance. Second round.
In all honesty, if we came in
those
here with just like one more spellcaster besides us, we would be fine.
Yeah, probably.
Get the fuck out of Dodge, really?
The problem
our problem is we don't have any AoEs this way.
Right.
Yeah, just imagine Dan and Zeno here, a moonbeam and shatter all over this place. Be great.
Yeah.
We've done it in like three rounds.
But also, you guys are casters and you were going into a room with no oxygen.
So, also for the record, Rabbit, that whirlwind doesn't take an action. That's just your move. You can set that off right now.
Oh, cool. Hey, guess who's going to go ahead and take a ride? The 11 people who are hitting me.
Also, to resolve one more thing, you do take another crit, which will be, let's see, 6, 9, 11. So
I have
five
never
more points
been,
after that.
I have never been polymorphed in all my years, thank you.
All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's going to be 9 sets of strength saves. Let's see.
Actually,
pass.
No. Fail. I might not actually recommend that because that actually stops you dead if you do that.
Oh, it does. All right.
Okay.
Then I will not.
I was
going
to say, well, that part's up to you, but.
No, I'm scooping up. I scooped up all the treasure. I scooped up. I scooped up the metal boy. You have the lizards. We are going into the rune. I am flying over, up and over into the rune.
All right. Fly up and over into the rune, to the rune with...
with Enoch. Yes.
And as you are teleported, just a hot second.
See, we went down. It's better. He dragged us into the shadows, Caitlin. What other mysteries await?
It'll be so much fun. Let's discover
right,
it together.
Check.
Hooray!
So, first things first, as I'm gonna go ahead and read the description again. Poink! You once again find yourself in front of the mirror of life trapping.
Oh!
I need you to make a wisdom saving throw as you teleport and are looking right at it.
God.
Which one of us?
Okay. You get a +4 to it.
And it's a what? Wisdom or charisma? Hard. What was the save?
Wisdom save.
You get a +4 to it.
Natural 20 for 30.
You're 21. Fine. You're fine. I got a roll for the lizard. The lizard gets sucked into the mirror and a mouse pops out.
Come on, dude!
He has a +4! He has a +4!
He has a +4!
He still failed, I'm sorry.
Why aren't you tucking him into the clothes like they usually are? I softly re- What are you doing? They're usually safe.
I did have control over this.
Now I'm yelling at Mila!
I'm sorry.
To be fair, why wouldn't the lizard be hiding somewhere? There was a lot of scary things going on.
They wild shaped, and also she wild shaped, and also the fucking.
Why are you suddenly putting my babies in danger?
Look, she doesn't care about many things.
Licky's gone through live minefield with no danger.
Don't kill the lizards, Villa.
And now?
They aren't dead. They're just in the gacha machine again.
Okay, name a single anime that was popular after the mascot animal died.
Anyway,
there was
anyway,
none!
Anyway.
Alright, so. That concludes Tyrant Bane's turn. Rue.
I'm gonna flip a coin. Real quick. Don't mind me.
Okay.
High or low, guys?
Low.
Wait, you can count numbers on coins?
If I get below 10, I'll follow you. If I get above that, I won't.
Oh no! Go high!
Oh, please go high.
No, we need you to run the gacha!
Alright, Rue, so what do you do?
So, what did I say? If I said I get above, I won't follow you.
Alright, so you follow onto the room.
Yep.
You teleport into the room with the mirror. Yep.
You get a +4.
Wisdom save. Using the whirlwinds, or using the stats of the... I forgot to specify this earlier. You need to use the mental stats of your...
Nah, if it's a wild shape.
Oh, no, wait, you're wild shape. You can use your stats, never mind.
Yep.
So, yeah, you pass. And then... Thankfully, the... And to specify earlier, yeah, Tyrant Bane picks up Licky. Licky is... Or no, you have Licky. Licky passed. So they are there.
Good.
Okay. But you look around and you see... A mouse on the floor.
Enoch grabs the mouse with Mage Hand. He runs back over to here. Just motions for everyone. Follow.
Alright.
Okay.
Well, let's go ahead and take you guys out of combat then.
Meanwhile, okay, there are the others up there. Huh, I wonder how everyone else is doing.
I'm pretty sure you would have heard Enoch.
I just wonder, we have heard Enoch yelling, follow!
Hold on, so where's my other lizard? He's not there, right?
He's going to Enoch will explain, but we're waiting for them to see if they hear us.
Yep. Perception checks for the rest of the party.
Sure.
Perception.
11.
Perception. And let's get Yuki. She'd probably hear this.
That's a 10.
Wow. 7. Yuki's not really paying attention.
You got 19, though.
I got 19, though.
Dan, you hear a commotion coming up from up past the stairs.
Something going on down that way.
Enoch just sees Rue and is just motioning. Come on, we gotta play the gotcha again if we want your lizard back.
She hears that and she just turns into a furious tornado. And then you just hear the what?
you just see Enoch being like blown everything around him as he's waving a mouse frantically with Mage Hand. We can start already. Just hurry back.
All right. So you throw a mouse. Another mouse comes in.
Grab that mouse. Rub it against the thing. We know the score.
You throw that one in. A frog comes out.
Get back in there.
I like to imagine that Rue is doing the tornado thing, and like as it circles, they just being tossed right back in.
Yep. All right, so you throw the frog in, mouse comes in. You throw that mouse in, another mouse comes in. You throw that mouse in, a frog comes out. You throw that frog in, another frog comes out.
Should we, unless there's literally anything else besides mice and frogs, should we just, fast forward until we get it, because she's not moving.
It takes about 5 to 10 more tries after that, but eventually you do get the lizard back up.
I think Dan would send Yuki to investigate.
By this time Yuki makes her way up. You hear, you hear her. Hey, what's going on up here?
a very gusty minotaur is just glowering down at Yuki with shining white eyes.
Oh. Oh. Wait.
Hi, Yuki.
That's not Rue, is it?
No, that's Tyrant Bane.
Oh. Wave. I see. What happened? Where's everyone else?
We're playing the gotcha for a lizard. We'll be back in a few minutes.
We went through a labyrinth. It's a story I'm not going to tell anybody in my tribe.
Why? Are you ashamed that you had to suck the bone air?
Wait, no, I was speaking as me. Tyrant Bane would tell the story to his tribe. I, however, loathe this.
I was saying, like, a ball game. You went to the labyrinth? Did you meet David Bowie?
God, I wish.
Oh, wait. He was a role model of mine when I was little. Anyway, it's not important.
Anyway, I will gust over to Rue and go, do you have a lizard? Oh, hold on.
Remember, Tyrant Bane, there's a safe distance.
Yep. She has them now, and she's just going to float over.
All
come
right.
On, come on, come on.
Let's just go back to our group, guys. We know where they are.
Okay. Very well, very well, very well.
So that was harrowing. Enoch takes the bag of holding, flips it upside down, pictures all of the treasure from within the sarcophagus as it just falls onto the floor. Which one of these is magic? He asks to himself as he, one second.
As you use your Eldritch Sight, you detect that the stringed instrument is giving off magic.
Okay. With Mage Hand, he will pick it up and put it back in the bag of holding. We've got the last of the nine gods. And he will put it back in. We will figure out what to do with it later. Also treasure.
Ooh.
Though,
as Biff kind of looks up, treasure, you say?
I wouldn't mess with that music box. It was basically designed to get us all killed.
At this point, what isn't designed to get us all killed in this damn place?
I don't know, but I'm never trusting a candle, sconce, or torch again.
I should actually make it clear that you can only speak Orin while you're that way.
Oh, okay. So he doesn't know, so he's just...
Maybe occasional bird squawks, how I picture.
She'll just turn to him. She'll just say, do you want to go back to normal?
This is kind of neat. I've never been this. This is what you wild shape in, right?
She nods.
Do I still have my horns? I don't. I'm just pointing at my head. Like...
I think you just look like a air elemental, I think.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, no.
I gotta say, flying around's kind of fun. Although I've never done it before, it must look really clumsy.
She shrugs. You get used to it.
Do you have a tip?
I mean, you know what the wind feels like. I guess I just like to imagine that.
Oh. Yeah, I'll try that. He instantly just skates into a wall. Just it takes some getting used to. He pats the wall.
So while they're having their moment,
but you can stop this.
Yes.
Oh, if it's disadvantageous in a tactical position, yes, I'd like to go back to being myself. But until then, just try skating back and forth and get used to it. This is kind of fun to him.
So, right. I was going to ask, how much treasure do we actually have here?
So, above game, what was inside the sarcophagus was 200 gold pieces, 5 moonstones, each worth 50 gold pieces, the fine red music box with golden trim, which is worth 250 gold pieces, and the mandolin.
All right, well, considering how much money we wasted with that last trap, with the trap just before this, is anyone got a problem with me just keeping the gold in escrow until we get out of here? And he points to the bag. This is escrow.
Not really.
What is an escrow?
That,
wait. He just keeps telling it, but it's just... he just has
so
no
did you name
idea.
The bag of holding escrow?
Just now, yes.
I like it.
It's a nice name. I don't have any issue with it, really.
Okay. And he'll scoop it all up in there. All right. Does anyone mind if we rest? Because it's been a very long 15 minutes.
I mean, no. Like,
we were basically just sitting here waiting for you. So, by all means, I guess, more the same.
I was about to say, Enoch gestures to the gashes along his torso. Yeah, I'd like to bleed against a wall for a little bit. Do-do-do-do-do. Collapses.
Sure, maybe long rest above game.
I mean, I'm fine with either as a warlock. That's up to everyone else. We did use a lot of spells because we fought the gargoyles. And the troll. And the other gargoyle. We've been going for a while.
Yeah, we've been taking a few beatings here and there.
I have seven smites left, but...
I can just do a short rest because that just gives me back my wild shape and I haven't really used that many spells, so I'm okay, but...
I'm only really low on fourth level slots. Everything else I'm basically full on.
Okay, so short rest sounds like it. Oh, go ahead.
I was gonna say, like, in terms of my spells, yeah, I'm fine with just a short rest. I got plenty to go off of.
In which case, Tyrant Bane, the spell gets dropped.
This is a short rest. I'm gonna
and
take
he,
some
and
of
he
these
turns
hit
back
die.
To normal.
And I turn back to normal. Oh yeah, how long does polymorph last? Like an hour or some shit?
An hour. Yep.
Oh, neato.
So we're just not rolling it again.
And I'm back up to full health and all my slots, so I'm happy.
I'm just gonna use one of these.
I guess.
Rich, get richer, baby!
Don't forget to add your con mod.
I know, that puts me back up to full, motherfucker.
Yay.
Alright, I'm back up.
Does it? Hold on. 16? Oh, pretty much.
All right, well, I'm back up to full by accidentally spamming my hit die.
Full.
All right. So, as you guys finish out your short rest, where would you like to go from here?
Well, looks like the only way to go is down, especially since we've now gotten all of the nine gods' various tools and or blessings.
Do we want to look at the most recent ones, see if anybody wants it?
Glances at Wimdy Rue, if she's even still Wimdy.
She's not Wimdy anymore.
Yeah. Glances at Rue.
I mean, I have mine already.
You know, I'd like to stop trying to want everything that we see. Can I try?
I mean...
Try.
You don't want to have fun with me anymore? Mm-hmm.
It's like, in his head, you've been more trouble than you're worth. Because I'm tired of hearing you every single time we find something. I
want
Do you say the more trouble than you're worth thing out loud or in your head?
In my head.
Hmm.
No, I know exactly what was going to happen if I said that out loud.
To be fair, Zeno, I say this with all due respect. I trust Nang Nang even less inside anyone beside you.
Actually, that's kind of nice, all things considered.
I'm going to take that as a compliment. I'm assuming you meant it to be.
He's still part of the ethos of a jungle and should be respected as such, but if you don't think he's a good fit for your psyche.
I mean, we could give Nang Nang to someone else, but I don't know who. Who wants the greedy trickster caught in their head?
Also notice that this man has been cursed multiple times since acquiring it.
You know, that's fair to let them know.
Just gestures at Waka that is just floating by him.
My man slowly turned into Crash Bandicoot over here.
And you just kind of look and you see Biff just kind of go to start, raise his hand, but as soon as you mention the part about him being cursed, he just kind of lowers it.
Yep, no shame. No shame in, like, realizing. In all honesty, him even being on here is a curse to begin with. We're just not sure if it's on him or us.
Thanks.
Calling it like I see it. Okay, right now we currently have the Mace of Wongo, the Mandolin of, I'm forgetting the Jakuli's name.
Shigambi.
And, and the Ring of, Obalaka.
Obalaka. I found an Unk thing and I pretty much just barrel rolled myself into it.
You yeeted the ring. Thing.
Vaughn, I loved everything about that. Thank you.
But yeah, we don't know what Wongos does, but we do know that he is not exactly the most liked of the trickster gods. Obalaka is extremely cautious to the point of being fearful, and Shigambi has some nobler sides, but it's a give and take with these guys.
Anybody good with a mandolin? In our current group?
That's not really an instrument that my people use.
I hold up lack of fingers that we need to play a mandolin.
Zeno's gonna be like, you know, actually I am, but you just said I can't do this, so.
Well, you can.
I mean, I suppose we could always put, you know,
I can always switch back.
Vlad will kind of make his way forward. You said you had something of. As he's just kind of ponders for a little bit. For Wongo?
Yes, it is a mace.
Yes.
Enoch will tip escrow over and envision the mace, and it'll plop onto the ground with a thunk.
You just see... Talon thinks about it for a moment. And as he goes to bend down... Red smoke seeds from the head of the mace, forming the outline of a monkey with a long tail. With a roar, the smoky apparition leaps at Talon, screaming, "Let me in!" And you see Talon just kind of collapse to a knee.
How are you feeling?
Well, how does he feel after taking one going?
He just explodes, what? Just...
No, he was the only one that knew magic out of our new group of friends.
No! Damn it!
I feel like my mind is stronger.
It's hard to explain, though.
Identify that for you now that you have the, you know, god in your head.
The True. Deity, the deity that my tribe worships is dwelling within me right now. I can assure you, it's a strange feeling.
Yeah, we should also point out that all these items are technically magical, besides, you know, bringing a spirit with them.
So, are you skilled in identification magics? Perhaps Dan might be able to go ahead and tell you a bit more about the mace that you wield. Do you need to lie down? Maybe rest for a second?
The Kanu steps forward after a moment. You said one of them was Shigambi, yes?
Yes, the mandolin.
Yeah, that. I've never actually seen one.
Enoch will carefully pull the mandolin out of his mage hand because he knows musical instruments are delicate. Even if they're magical.
Lucana will reach out and touch the mandolin, and you see six shadowy serpents slither out of the mandolin and coil around the Kanu. And you just see her just, her eyes open wide as she manages to stand her ground.
Kanu, are you okay?
She takes her left hand and she makes a fist that closes it up to her chest. Yes. I'll be fine.
Okay.
Very good. Welcome to our little band. Tyrant Bane will give like a half smile. Just.
Lakanu or Tyrant Bane, could you get Big Guy's attention over here?
Oh, yeah.
What?
Zol, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. In Omuan, I'll be like, brother, come.
So
kind of goes down and stoops down towards you, Enoch.
Yeah. So
I will introduce you real quick. He wishes to speak with you, this one.
Yeah. I remember from when Tyrant Bane had this ring, it adds a layer of protection to you. And since you're one of our biggest fighters, I think that might benefit you the most.
It has the... I will translate that to him for you. And then I'll also add, it also goes ahead and has a tendency to make you cautious. It didn't stop me too much in my duty. She was more merciful as to what my mission was. But would that be something that you would be... But would that be something that you would consent to?
He kind of snorts, looks over to Lucanu, and you hear Lucanu say, I'm sure it'll be fine. More strength for you. You see him just take a single large meaty finger, and he'll go and touch the ring. And as Zol touches the ring, find that description again. Da, 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 all the way towards. Where are you, Obelaka?
I can't wait to see Tyrant Bane of the Sword Coast. He's going to do so much translating.
Meanwhile, Dan sitting over here has a booth set up somehow. Identify your magic items. 5 gold.
It's just a sandwich sign just worn around the dog.
Exactly.
As Zol touches the ring, the dust swirls into the shape of a small feral bear-like creature that billows towards him with a ghostly roar. And he doesn't even flinch as he just kind of looks up. You see, he had more of a stoic face, but you kind of see him contort to like a more of like a surprised, slightly concerning look.
Are you well?
Yes, I'm I'm fine. And you see him just kind of go and takes his free hand as he has his great axe resting on it. He just kind of grabs it and touches it. I'll be fine.
Very good.
Well, that seems to take care of that matter as you see Biff just kind of look around the rest of you. Well, what next?
It seems we are getting down to the end of this. The nine gods have vessels. They walk with us. Keep in mind, all of you have recently attuned. You can commune to the god within you. It's as easy as just closing your eyes and just thinking a question. It's hard to explain, but it's something I don't think can be explained.
Yeah. Someone else want to say something?
Oh, I was going to say, yeah, I mean, my god's been kind of quiet, but, you know, I'm comfortable with Moa up in here.
Moa just gives you the finger guns from somewhere in your cortex.
Yeah.
Which exactly. Is funnier because they're a snake.
Yeah, it just gets hands out of nowhere.
Conjure greater hand.
You hear Moa in your head, Dan. I personally find your company quite comforting.
And smiles at that. Glad you're in here too.
Meanwhile, Tyrant Payne and Unk are just like, he's another to his head. So where to from here? Can I go ahead and say not the candle? Never the candle.
That room doesn't exist anymore. It's wiped from the map. Ignore it.
Enoch just gestures to the rope that Rue already dangled down into the pit. Seems like our only path.
Oh, I must have been going ahead and doing preparations or something. Sometimes Unk makes you lose track of time sometimes. So where do you think this leads? I understand.
Well, yeah, just me and Unk just You like football?
Yes.
just the Simpsons Gerald Ford.
Well, Tyrant Bane, let us drink beer and watch football.
Alright.
So this leads further down. How much further? Because it can't be too much longer now, right?
Well, according to... Oh, go ahead.
Sorry. Yeah, as you, Tyrant Bane, as you take your flame tongue longsword and you look down, yeah, it's about 15 feet down.
Okay.
Well,
Sorry, you go, buddy. Before we go down, again, anybody want their magic items identified before we move forward? Figure out what they do? Be good?
I mean, that's the NPC's thing, so.
Yeah, that's what Stan's asking for the NPCs. Do they want them identified? Do they not want them identified? They figured out themselves and want to not share with the class.
Because deep down, Dan is a creature of knowing, and he's got to know.
They're really, really cool, though. They're god items. He wants to know. And also, it'd probably be advantageous for the rest of us to know what their items do.
He's going to go right back to the rest of his folks and be like, you will never believe what the fuck happened today.
Hello?
I'm sorry. I was looking up something else.
Oh, okay. Dan was asking if the NPC is one of the things identified.
Yeah.
Well... Biff just kind of looks, I am curious about the instrument.
Ed will hold out his hands and take whatever anybody wants so he can begin identifying them.
I've heard legends about instruments being used to go ahead and ward off creatures.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you cast Identify on the mandolin.
Mm-hmm.
This is an instrument of the bard, specifically a Caniff mandolin. It is a wondrous item, which is rare, but it requires attunement by a bard. An instrument of the bards is an exquisite example of its kind, superior to an ordinary instrument in every way. 7 types of these instruments exist, each named after a legendary bard college. Specifically, with the Knaith mandolin, any creature that attempts to play the instrument without being attuned to it must succeed on a DC 15 wisdom saving throw or take 2d4 psychic damage. You can use an action to play the mandolin and cast one of its spells. Once the instrument has been used to cast a spell, it can't be used to cast that spell again until the next dawn. The spells use your spell casting ability as spell save DC. You can play the instrument while casting a spell that causes any of its targets to be charmed on a failed saving throw, thereby imposing disadvantage on the save. The effect applies only if the spell has a somatic or material component. With a Knaith mandolin, you have the ability to cast Cure Wounds at 3rd level, Dispel Magic, and Protection from Energy, Lightning only.
Dan will share with everybody. So this would be better in the hands of a bard, but I mean, you could play it. You just have to risk taking, and he taps his head, damage to your brain.
Above game, I'm kind of like, wow, if Zeno had died when I thought he was going to, and I was able to roll up Rhodey and get him out here, he'd be like, I want it, it's mine.
So yeah. None of us are bards, right? We got sorcerers.
Nope.
Oh, so I forgot to mention. I'm sorry. There's a few other things that are also on that apply for all the instruments. You can also cast fly, invisibility, levitate, and protection from evil and good.
It's a lot of good stuff, but none of us are bards, to my knowledge.
So
correct.
So we went
through all of that for an item that's class locked.
Yep.
Sure, I think all of these are to a certain extent class locked.
I mean, I suppose the Rod of the Serpent could be used by anybody, really. Anyone who wants to summon a serpent.
Oh, poor rabbit.
Dan!
Well, no. Rabbit. We went through all of that to get the spirit of Shigambi. The loot was just extra. In Mandalorian. Yeah.
I'm calmer now.
Yes. And we put
Thank
in
you.
We also put in probably our best NPC, which is Talal.
It's so, true.
Yes.
We're fine.
So okay.
I'm fine.
Besides, you were fine. You didn't get hurt that badly.
You enter a room casually with 48 monsters and go, huh! Like,
yeah, you were fine. You had 90 extra XP plus whatever health you got.
Plus resistance.
If you didn't turn me into an air elemental, I would be a hamburger. I appreciate you. I'm gonna bake you cookies one day.
Hooray, I love cookies.
Oh, cookies are great.
Alright, so we all ready to head into the pit?
So, who wants to descend down first?
Would you like me to lead the way? I have a light source. It would probably help.
I can lie down, but I probably shouldn't be leading the charge. Oh, wait! I can just turn invisible and lead the charge.
Oh, actually, if you're doing that, I will... Would you mind if I just held on? And so it would just look like I'm floating down. No one would see you.
Sure.
But while we're doing this, we're just climbing down. All right. The Tyrant Bane is overjoyed. He loves flying now.
I was going to say, like, above game, do you want Zeno to cast fly on Tyrant Bane?
Nope, I'm fine. Just dangling down into a hole, just holding the... Just one beefy arm holding the broom and the other one just dangling, holding the flame-tongued sword as a light sword.
So, let's go ahead and get you guys over towards this map here.
New map.
For the sake of argument, Yuki's probably just sitting in Dan's lap as he flies down.
Just making Invisidog.
Oh, and Mila, just in case this happens to come up again, my lizards are in my cloak now.
Okay, good to know. So, I assume you're going to be the first one down here.
Me? Oh, yeah.
Or Tyrant Bane.
Tyrant Bane, Dan, and Yuki.
All right, so we'll start with Tyrant
the power, Bane. The power pairs there.
Yeah.
As I go to reveal the map, Tyrant Bane, I want you to roll a d20 for me.
Just a flat d20?
Yes, sir.
Gotcha. That is a 16, sir.
Let me set the scene for you as this all pans out. Da, 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 da. I need to get to the right page again. There we go. A pungent stench fills this pentagonal room, the walls of which are covered with riveted sheets of iron. A wild garden full of sickly plants and rotting compost takes up most of the interior, and a narrow path hugs the wall between two exits. Jutting from the middle of the garden is a 6-foot-tall rusty sprinkler. In the ceiling above the sprinkler is the 10-foot shaft from which you have came. And Tyrant Bane, as you're the first one, place yourself right
in the here. Dotted line?
Yes, right there.
Okay. Give me just a second.
Oh. Hello? Hello?
You hear a voice in your head.
Unk, is that you?
No, that wasn't me. Hello?
Hello, hi. Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Oh.
Where are you?
I'm somewhere here. I think I'm over by the water. What's your name?
I'm Tyrant Bane of Omu. I'm of some blades of Napaka.
Oh, hi. Oh.
What's your name?
What is my name? I don't remember.
Let me guess. Been down here a very long time?
I think so.
Well, that's no good.
Do you have friends with you? Are you by yourself?
It would be a feat even for me if I made it down here all by myself. But no, I do have allies with me.
You have friends?
Oh, I do.
Can I meet them?
I don't see why you couldn't.
Oh boy, I love meeting new people. Oh, we'll have so much fun if we get to see each other.
And as you make your way down, who's next? Dan?
Because I airlifted Tyrant Bane down with Yuki in my lap. I'm invisible, though.
Roll a d20 for me.
All right. Oop, let me move the turn order out of the way so I can properly click it. That is a 3.
Well, well, well. What do we have here? Come down for the ritual, have you?
Ritual? Explain, please. Can I get a name as well? While we're, chatting.
Give me just a hot second above the table.
You may call me Gleerul, mortal.
Gleerul. Pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Oh, such a pleasure to know you as well.
So, my name is Galinda, and you can call me Dan if you like. My friends do. Ritual, huh? What about that ritual?
the master has quite the ritual coming up for the end of all things. Oh, I can't wait for it. But first, oh, I think you'll do nicely.
As you hear that cut out, roll a d20 for Yuki.
Sure. Ah, dang it. There we go. She gets a 10.
Hello. Hello? Oh! Are you another friend of Tyrant Beans? Huh? Huh? Hmm?
You hear, Yuki kind of turn around a little bit. Huh?
Yeah? Yeah?
Oh, yeah. They're really nice, they're really nice people. Yeah, yeah. And you see Yuki just kind of turn towards you, Dan.
I hear a voice in my head.
I heard one in mine, too. Was yours as ominous as the one in mine?
No, they sound nice.
Oh, wait, good. You guys can... Just Tyrant Bane looking up at nothing, just hanging. You guys can hear it, too.
So, I met an individual by the name of Galirul, and he spoke of a ritual that I'm guessing a Sirak is doing that will lead to the end of all things.
He must be getting restless to hasten the Black Day again.
Mm-hmm.
The one I heard. Oh, you go.
I was gonna say, like, Bub gave, like, I was gonna cast Fly on myself, and I guess one or two other people who wanted. So I roll a d20 for it.
Sure, Zeno, as you make your way down.
That's just to double check. Okay, good.
For the record, Rue was climbing down the rope as well.
Alright, well, Rue first. You roll a d20.
Huh? Oh, yes.
Yeah, we'll do Rue first and then Zeno.
Yeah, 13.
Oh, more of you. Fascinating.
You hear as you make your way down.
She just kind of looks around quizzically.
And Zeno, you hear as you make your way down.
Oh. The more the merrier. I would probably take great pride in having you as my subjects.
Again, line, buddy, I have two other people that are constantly in my head.
Oh, come now. Don't be so brash with me.
As you hear that voice cut out. Who's next?
I guess Enoch will start climbing down the rope.
All right, Enoch, make a d20 for me.
Do 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 do. Natural one.
Would be able to even get into its head, considering like his head runs on like Linux.
We went to the same place, Rabbit. Thank you.
You're welcome. I was even thinking of that or AMD, so.
No. This one is rather curious.
Oh, great. Another new voice in my head.
Yeah, it sucks, doesn't it?
No. I am but more than just a voice. I am as ancient as even the one who is my master is. But alas, even I must succeed to him in time.
As he cuts out.
Neat.
Who's next?
I'll go, I guess. Alright, Elise will basically just like grapple down with the rope.
Roll d12 for me.
12.
Hello. Oh. Another friend. Are you one of the friends that Tyrapy was talking about?
Kind of looks around for a second. I suppose so, yes.
Oh, goody. I always love making new friends. I'm down by the water if you ever want to hang out.
Lays looks to Tyrant Bane. Did you hear the same thing I did?
A kind voice who says they're hanging down by the river? I mean, down by the water?
Yes.
Man.
Hmm.
You all got a kind voice. I got a scary voice.
No, we got that one too.
Oh, okay. I'm not alone. All right. I feel a little better now.
I would have been concerned if they were just something was just targeting you.
Yeah.
And as the rest of the party begins to descend down the rope by their various means, and one by one as you're looking at each of them, you're getting rather confused. Some of them are like confused, like weirded out. Some of them are rather mortified. As you're pondering the messages that you have all received, that's where we're going to end our session for tonight.
Yay!
I did want to make one observation. How thick is this gas that we're like around in here? How far see through it?
It's not gas. It's just piles of like sickly plants and vegetation and piles of rotting compost.
Oh, okay. I thought it was like gas or something.
No.
Just vegetation.
Yeah, no one goes down to level 5. It smells like poo gas.
You know, someone has not been taking care of this. They really need to get their garden revoked from them.
All right. Well, now that we're wrapping up for the night, let's start doing our outros. Caitlin, where can they find you?
Hello, I'm CaitlinC37. You can find me on Twitch, Twitter, Tumblr, and Mastodon at CaitlinC37. Commissions are open, so if anybody wants any paintings or drawings or things like that, you can find all my information there.
Lovely. Moving down the list, DeLuna, where can they find you?
You can find me on Twitch and YouTube at DeLuna13 on Twitter, because I will be down with this ship till it kicks me off. There's underwater at DLittle1338. On Sundays, we are playing Power Rangers Cyber Strike on Twitch Person's YouTube channel. I was like leading to Dan or Draco. Me and him were talking while he was playing through Kingdom Hearts 1 the other day. That was really fun.
Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot. It's nice to have someone else chat while you're playing.
Alrighty, then Milla, where can they find you?
Well, when you can't find me here DMing for this lovely bunch of groups of players I am fortunate to have, you can find me on Twitter at Milla Lynch and Nerd. You can also find me starting up again some point soon on Twitch at Milla Ninja. I'm thinking I might be streaming Pokemon Scarlet and or Violet when they come out, possibly doing a Nuzlocke, as is tradition. And you can also find me Monday nights at twitch.tv/LeJake, where we play through Trials of Vito's Horde of the Dragon Queen, in which I play Duster, the skulky-looking Kenku fighter. I know, right? Kenku, that's not a road, but we're having a blast as the town is being besieged by some unknown raiders with a dragon. It's getting late into the night on that front, so how will the town fare as these raiders bear down and steal treasure? Tune in Monday night and find out.
Lovely. Shaka, where can they find you?
Hi, find me here on Tuesdays playing Elise. You can find me along with DeLuna over on twitch.tv/twitchtheperson for Power Rangers Cyberstrike, where I play our resident Red Ranger, Marika Hammond. And otherwise, you can find me over on Twitter at ChakoZombie101 because, I mean, it's Twitter. What else can I say?
Fair enough. Draco, where can they find you?
Everyone, you can find me on YouTube as Draco Magnius. You can find me on Twitter at DMagnius. And you can find me right here on Twitch as Draco underscore Magnius. I stream every Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. On Wednesday, we're going to be streaming Skyward Sword some more. That's going to be at 10 p.m. East Standard Time. We've just beaten the Imprisoned. So now we're going to get yeeted into the Farron Woods where there's a flood, apparently. On Thursday, it's AI the Somnium Files. Our investigation continues, and we're in a significantly better timeline than the last one. But I'm not going to say much more because I don't want to spoil anything for Caitlin. And then on Saturday, me and Deluna are going to be playing some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. We are going to be doing the games, the very first, the Phil Cup, and then we're going to move on to the next worlds, which I believe are Agrabah and Monstro are coming next.
Actually, you beat the games already, so now it's just going to Agrabah or Halloween Town, whichever one.
No, the Phil Cup is open to us. We didn't actually do the Phil Cup yet. We're going to go through that, and then we're going to move to the next worlds.
I can't believe they put Mike Wazowski in an RPG. So great.
They did.
They did.
That's way later, though, because he's just playing Kingdom Hearts 1. So.
Yeah. We still got a whole mess of games to get through before we get to Mike Wazowski.
Alrighty, and Rabbit, where can they find you?
Yo, what's up? My name's Rabbit. I'm a writer and a comedian. You can go ahead and find me on Twitch and Twitter at Hey Mr. Rabbit. That's HEYMRRABBIT for all you at home. I stream throughout the week. I stream RPGs, retro games, and horror games. Everything's I got going on. Been working on a demo reel and been trying out for a bunch of different video games. Will I get them? Time will tell. Who knows? Ooh. But anyway, yeah, that's me. That's what I got going on right now.
All right, and before I do me, I'd like to do our quote of the week, which goes to not Tyrant Bane, but Rabbit the player. The maker of this game cannot hide behind his OCs.
He can't!
Oh, that's beautiful. But yes, you have
the
already...
Sirek made a bad dungeon. Shut the fuck up.
Yes, you've already found me here at twitch.tv/BurnoutVaughn. You can find me on YouTube and Twitter at BurnoutVaughn, where... I'll keep you posted on things. Like I said, there's most likely not going to be a regular Satire Day stream with X, Wily, Willy this week. We might try to push it back to Sunday. It all depends on how things are going with both my new work schedule and things going on this weekend. But also, I will keep everyone posted on the next D&D miniseries we are doing, which is looking to be a heist game set sometime around December 30th. So mark your calendars and get ready for Fridays around that time. We might have some very interesting players for this next one. And now that it's time to raid, does anyone have an objection with us hitting up Connor?
I have a
person if you wanted to change things up a little bit.
I was going to say, I've got Bosco on. He's doing his Halo 3 stuff.
True. I mostly wanted to get to Connor because Connor's actually been raiding into us a lot. In various streams, and I want to return the favor because that's been very nice of him. We've gotten a lot of people catching up on Chult the Personality and our other D&D games over on the YouTube from following through on raids. So I want to return the love. So be on the lookout for us sometime next Tuesday. And I still have a good raid message. Keep the lizard safe.
Keep the lizard safe.
Keep the lizard safe.
Alrighty, you all have a good time, and we will see you next week. Bye-bye.
Good night, everybody.
Bye-bye.